It's time for The Match Game. Hollywood Squares. Our with From Days of Our Lives, Sean Stevens. From The Fall Guy, Mark E. Post. From Goodnight Beantown, Jim Stahl. Stars of The Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour, Gene Rayburn and John Bauman.
Another winning one?
Yeah.
Thank you.
I think, Gene, this is a better group than we had yesterday, isn't it? Yes. They're okay. What do you want to do, Marty?
I don't know. Notice I'm wearing my beautiful black and purple ensemble.
We're all dressed up. We ought to have something for you to do.
These are my school colors from the Institute of Driver Training. You know.
What do you say we have a go at the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour? Are you ready for that?
Good
Let's
idea.
Begin by greeting our stars. A really? Round of applause for our stars. Hello, stars.
Hey.
Hello there.
Hey. Oh, he's
welcome.
I got another one today.
What's that? You got another frog?
Yeah, this little guy right here.
Oh, thank you.
Goodness.
He
gracious.
Doesn't have a name yet, though.
That is a very small frog.
It certainly is.
You can see it. It looks like an elephant from here, but it is a frog indeed.
Yes.
It brought you luck yesterday.
Yes. In fact, yesterday's question had something to do with flies, and this one's eating a fly.
Uh-huh. It didn't help Fern, who was sitting in the upstage seat, did it? Hello there. How is it feeling up there? Hello, Blake.
Hello, Jane.
So you want to get in show business, eh?
Sure. I don't have a frog, though.
You don't
I left him at home.
Well, we can do something for you. I see. You're wearing your medal there?
That's Vietnam service.
Uh-huh. All right, sir.
Served in Vietnam.
Wonderful.
With a frog.
Yeah.
Ready? Ready? Ready?
I want to win big, Gene.
You want to win big?
I want to win big.
You're a winner in my book. Oh, I love your velvet. Let's say hello to our two players over here, Maury Gersh and Deborah Dismuke.
Hey!
Hello there.
How are you?
Hi, Maury. Tell us about you, please.
I'm from Burlingame, California.
Yeah.
And in a couple of days, I will have my 75th birthday and 50th wedding anniversary.
Wow! That's wonderful. Congratulations.
Thank you.
My best wishes to the bride.
Right. I have two children.
Yeah.
Two grandchildren and two hobbies, tournament bridge and racquetball.
You still play racquetball?
After heart surgery.
After heart surgery?
Yep.
Are you sure you're up to this? There's going to be a lot of excitement here.
No problem.
Okay, Maury. Good luck to you.
Thank you.
Hi, Deborah.
Hello.
Let's find out about you, please.
Well, I come from a terrific family. I'm the youngest of seven children.
Wow.
I'm an aspiring actress.
Yeah.
And I'm thrilled to be here.
Well, we're thrilled to have you here, Deborah.
Thank you.
Now, let's begin, shall we? Let me just explain briefly. The object here is to match as many of our celebrities as you can. The one who's done that most often at the end of the third round will be the winner. And that person will go on to challenge our returning champion on Hollywood Squares with a chance to win up to $30,000. Now, Maury, you won the toss. That means you have to go first. Do I push the button or don't I push the button?
Try it, but it won't work.
Try it, but it won't work. Yes, it works.
Yay!
It works. So, do you want A or B, Maury?
A.
Yes, sir. You've got it. I tell you what, we're laughing at a little inside joke here. We had a little problem with the Dropbox there, and we thought we were going to have to work it manually. There was a guy was going to sit here, back here, you see, and open this little box and do it all by hand. I mean, you have no idea how complicated it is in there.
Village
has. But anyway, it's working now.
The box.
Yes. Ralph said. My wife's so afraid our waterbed is going to burst, she comes to bed wearing a blank. You ever sleep in a waterbed, Maury?
No.
No? Do you want to?
No.
Okay. Frog is ready. All right, we're ready up in the upper lane.
Once it's in there, do I have to leave it in there?
What's that?
Once it's in there, that's it, right?
No, you can take it. You want to change your mind? It's a woman's privilege. No, that's all right. Leave it in there. That's a good answer. Hey, Maury. Ralph said my wife's so afraid our waterbed is going to burst, she comes to bed wearing a blank.
Scuba gear.
Scuba gear.
Yeah.
What a way to go, Maury. He said scuba beer, a rather inventive answer, I thought, Sean.
Well, first of all, I'd like to say happy birthday and happy anniversary to Maury. And,
thank you.
As a gift, I'd like to give you this.
Oh,
cool. Wow. Uh-huh.
One.
But you're going to say a frog.
I think this is a match, Gene. If it isn't, I'm going to punch you right in the nose.
No. I'll get the judge up here. You can punch him in the nose. Snorkel.
Well, that's
not Chief.
No, SCUBA is an acronym for self-contained underwater breathing apparatus.
Yeah.
And a snorkel is a thing you just put in your mouth.
Oh, that was good.
All right.
Considering you just made it up, it was excellent. Yeah.
What do you say, Blake?
I didn't say scuba gear, but you have to wear this when you have scuba gear if you don't want to go down. I said a life preserver.
A life preserver. It's mandatory to wear one of those.
It certainly is.
All right, John. My wife's so afraid her waterbed is going to burst, she comes to bed wearing a...
Well, I'm a New Yorker, but I think this is the thing that those weirdos in California wear when they go into the ocean. A wetsuit?
A wetsuit.
Yeah.
Right.
A snorkel is part of it. It matched.
Right.
Yeah, it's self-contained, underwater breathing wetsuit.
I have been in that waterbed.
Wetsuit.
I said wetsuit.
All right. Okay, so it's three for Maury. Marky.
Let's end this good round, this otherwise good round, with a bummer. I said life preserver.
No, it's not a bummer. Life preserver was a very good response.
Oh, okay.
Excellent response.
I feel better then.
Yeah, because it's very logical to go to bed with a life preserver if you think the waterbed's going to break. You ever been in the waterbed?
Yeah.
Oh, you have? Oh. End of interview. Here we go. Unlucky Louie said, I'll tell you why my voice is so high. Yesterday I went to the zoo and tried to play leapfrog with a blank. That's why my voice is so high. That's why I'm talking funny like this.
You went to the zoo.
Went to the zoo and tried to play leapfrog with a blank.
With a blank.
Did you know Nidra is 75?
Nidra isn't 75.
Yes, she is.
Nidra? Really? Are you really?
Yeah, I'm older than Mario because I'm
Uh-huh.
I think we should have a little hand wrestling and see who's the toughest.
A little hand wrestling between Nidra and Maury?
Yeah.
All right, here we go.
And the loser goes on the waterbed with...
Unlucky Louie said, I'll tell you why my voice is so high. Yesterday I went to the zoo and tried to play leapfrog with a blank.
Kangaroo?
A kangaroo?
Yeah.
How would that make his voice high?
I don't know. I'm so sorry.
Oh, he's too high to get over to jump over a kangaroo. How tall is a kangaroo? About so high?
It's about
the little ones are even lower than that.
They got some small ones, too. What do you say, Sean?
Well, I just tried to think of the tallest thing at the zoo, and I came up with a giraffe.
Yeah, that would be difficult to play leapfrog with a giraffe.
That's a pretty good.
This could be very dangerous. A rhino.
A rhino. Oh, yeah, that'll make a tenor out of you in an instant.
That could be very dangerous.
What do you say?
I said that could be a dangerous too, especially if he's got a horn. Rhinoceros.
Right. Did you know that a rhinoceros horn is made out of hard hair?
It certainly is.
Right.
How hard is it?
Sore fingernail.
It's very hard.
And it's supposed to be supposed to be an aphrodisiac, too.
Oh, it is?
Yeah, it certainly is. Sure, and if you jump over it and land on it, it probably is an aphrodisiac. Because anything after that is going to feel better.
I'll tell you why my voice is so high. Yesterday I went to the zoo and tried to play leapfrog with a...
Yes, I'm afraid I'm... one of the animals on the panel that didn't match giraffe.
Giraffe is very good, isn't it? An excellent answer. What do you say, Jim?
I gave the quality answer giraffe, and it's
right.
Wrong.
No, that's not wrong.
It's
excellent. Don't feel
I know
bad.
I failed as a human being.
No, you didn't. No.
I should have read her mind.
That's all right. Oh, Jim.
No.
Okay.
Gene.
Well, I think that would happen because everybody that said giraffe.
What have you got for us?
Well, this takes a little visualization. A camel.
A camel? That would hurt. Two humps. Yeah, right. You'd have to play. You'd have to do a double jump each time, wouldn't you? Yeah, hump, hump. That's right. Okay, there's round one. Maury's ahead 3-0. Round two coming up in a moment. Watch this first, if you please. Hurry back. Let's go. Round two coming up. Ready. Now, Maury, you're ahead. That means you have to go first.
A, please.
A it is. For Maury, round two. The White House aide said to President Reagan, "You better throw out that jelly bean jar, Mr. President. One of the jelly beans is blanking." You don't play because you matched in the previous round. Neither do you, nor do you.
It's not blanking.
Better throw out that jelly bean jar, Mr. President. One of the jelly beans is blanking.
Oh, wow. Black is beautiful.
Black is beautiful. Here we go. Ready? Everybody ready?
Yeah.
Yep. Yes. Maury. White House aide said to the president, "You better throw out that jelly bean jar, Mr. President. One of the jelly beans is blanking."
Ticking.
Ticking. You got it, Maury.
That's a good answer.
Good answer.
Hey, that's a good answer, Maury.
It's okay. He's that's right on the ball, good. Isn't he, Nidra?
Did he do? He didn't. Oh.
I'll run the show, Nidra. Okay.
Yeah, you'll just do
it. Good answer. I said jumping.
Jumping jelly beans. Yeah.
You did know, he write an answer? Huh?
If you had been playing, what would your answer have been?
Oh, I don't get to play?
No.
Oh.
No, because you matched in the previous round, you see.
Oh,
and once you
that's
match,
the way the game works.
Once he's got you, he's got you.
Oh.
And he's got you. Maury's guy, he's had you in the previous round.
Can I show anyway?
Sure, show. Ticking.
Oh. Hey, great minds work alike. Huh? Have you got a frog with you, Maury?
No, yeah.
I just thought, well, I said, same as my head, moving all the
moving,
time.
Moving. That's good. He doesn't play. He doesn't play. She do. Hello there.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm fine, thank
you. Want a show?
Sure.
Okay, go.
I said buzzing, beeping, or making an electrical noise.
Hey.
What do you
think?
What
about that? Now, wait a minute. Let him take it over.
Take it up the mat.
Yes.
Hey, that's
yes.
The mat.
Yes.
That's the mat.
Yes,
that's the mat.
They
thought about it, and they finally gave it to you, Maury.
Thank you.
But it was a little difficult for them to do.
How can you write all that stuff in a minute?
Where are we? Here we are. Catch up if you can, Deborah. Here we go. The hospital patient said, "The kitchen must have run out of bowls. The nurse just served me my soup in a blank."
Boy.
Not much thinking going on there. Everybody went right to an answer. Deborah. The hospital patient said, "The kitchen must have run out of bowls. The nurse just served me my soup in a blank."
Bedpan.
In a bedpan. Deborah said deadpan, Sean.
I get to play?
Yes.
Okay.
Don't you want to play? Sure.
I want to play. I'd like to play.
What do you say?
Bedpan.
Bedpan. One for Debbie. Everybody plays because she hasn't matched anybody yet.
Bedpan.
Two bedpans coming up.
You need a bedpan. I said it, a bedpan.
Get a bedpan. Three. One more and you tie him. Okay. The kitchen must have run out of bowls. The nurse just served my soup in a
bedpan.
Four.
One more. I'll put him ahead with a bedpan.
He's ahead. 5-4. Parky. Another bedpan.
Wow. Yeah.
In one fell swoop, or one swell poop. Okay, Maury, you'll have one more shot to catch up with it and achieve a tie. Let's see what happens in the third and final round right after this. Here we go with the third and final round. Now, Maury, since she's matched everyone, you're going to have to go first this time, and you have one shot at it here, A or B.
A again.
A again. Two people play. You got to match them both to achieve a tie and stay in the game. It's Nidra and Blake. Are you ready?
Yes, yeah. We certainly
this
are.
This is it. Louis the Lumberjack is really tough.
How tough is Louis the
Lumberjack? I'm glad you asked. He's the only guy in the world who cuts his nails with a blank.
Why would a lumberjack cut nails?
Because he wants to.
Only lumberjack in the world who cuts his fingernails.
Oh, his fingernails.
You don't have to worry about it, do you?
All right, Maury.
Yeah, you don't even play, and why are you wondering about it? You should not even be listening to what we're up here saying when we're not writing.
Here we go. Louis the Lumberjack is really tough. He's the only guy in the world who cuts his nails with a blank.
With an axe.
With an axe. All right, Maury. Number of good possibilities here. Axe
good
is one of them.
Good answer.
It was.
Good answer. You got to match them both. A buzzsaw, so that means Deborah wins the game. Come on down, Deborah. Right here, if you would, please. Hang around here, and I'll get back to you in a moment. Maury, happy wedding anniversary.
Thank you.
And thank you, and happy birthday, too, and thank you for being here. We're going to send you some gifts that I hope you like. Maury Gerst, ladies and gentlemen. Congratulations to you, Deborah. Aha!
It's Joe!
Now, here it comes. Here comes our big sweat. We're going to switch to Hollywood Squares. We're going to bring on three more celebrities who will occupy those three seats up there. And I'm going to change places with John Bauman here, who will be hosting Hollywood Squares. Don't go away, friends. We'll be right back.
A member of our studio audience will receive Kenya's beautiful blue-white gems, set in earrings, pendant, and tie tech. Mountings are in 14-karat solid gold for men and women, furnished by Kenya Gems. And now, it's time for more of the match game. Hollywood Squares, our quiz from Dallas, Audrey Landers. Arsenio Hall. Travelina. And taking over the star of the Hollywood Squares, John Bauman.
And we'll be right back.
Now, John Bauman and the Hollywood Squares.
Thank you, G-Wood, and welcome to the second half of the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour.
I am here with Deborah Dismukes, who survived the match game because a lovely 75-year-old woman gave a lovely 75-year-old man the axe with a buzzsaw. Or something to that effect. I am also here with three lovely new celebrities, Audrey, Fred, and Arsenio. Arsenio, you're flaring.
Well, yeah, I'm trying to, I'm trying to wear this. It's real tight, and I feel like I'm about to have a nervous breakdown.
That's because they're Marquis pants.
You know, Arsenio, it's Arsenio's second time on our show in its brief history. And is that because you like the show so much or because we pay you, Arsenio?
It's both. I love it. I love working with Gene, and I love working with John. And, you know, this show is doing real well. As a matter of fact, combining the two formats, they're going to combine, NBC's going to combine Marcus Welby, MD, and the A-Team now. And it should be interesting because you'll have Mr. T said, "You ain't no doctor, fool! Ain't nothing wrong with my hair, I cut it like this!" You know, and it should be real interesting, I think. I'm looking forward to seeing it. Sucker!
Well, Deborah, maybe you're an aspiring actress. Maybe someday you'll be lucky enough to appear on Arsenio's new show. Right now, I'm afraid you're stuck with Match Game Hollywood Squares. Let's go and play Hollywood Squares.
And before we get into the game, we once again will meet our defending champion. Her name is Lori Gause. She is returning with $15,175.
Not bad.
I feel great.
Why don't you tell us a little bit about yourself as a reminder?
I come from Hemet, California. I have two children, and I work at a health club.
Mm-hmm. Well, you're certainly doing well so far, and it's not over yet. Once again, we will play Hollywood Squares. We'll play it until you hear the Time's Up bell. Whoever's ahead at that time is our winner. Goes on to play Supermatch for up to $30,000. Our first game is worth $100 plus $25 for every square that either of you captures. Our champion always has the privilege of starting. That is you, Lori. Pick a square. Let's go.
Let's go with Gene again.
Gene Rayburn.
Right.
What are there more of, Gene? Cells in your body or people in China?
Well, let's see. There are a billion people in China.
And your body has far more than a billion cells in it, because you cannot see a body cell with the naked eye. So put them all together. Look at this body, for instance. I mean, just...
Well, it's taller than the average body.
They're,
starvation diet. So
yeah, but they're a lot more than a billion cells.
Is that Ed Bagley, Jr.?
Not Ed Bagley, please. Okay, Lori, Gene says that there are more cells in your body than there are people in China. For the first square, agree or disagree?
I'll agree.
There are more cells in your body. Yes, you get the first square and $25. And Gene, just to show you how accurate Gene was, there really are about a billion people in China. Well done. There are more than 10 trillion cells in your body.
Really?
Okay, Deborah.
Carl Sagan can't even say the number. That's so
how big it is.
Your move, Deborah. Pick a square.
I would like Nidra, please.
Nidra Vols. Which did the White House have first, Nidra? A telephone or indoor plumbing?
You ask me all these old questions. I understand. I'm not mad.
Okay, Nidra. Good. I wouldn't want to get on your bad side, Nidra.
You can't insult me. I'm too ignorant. All righty. The White House turlet. Or what was that other little article?
It's a telephone.
Telephone?
Yeah.
Oh.
Hope they knew the difference.
I don't remember them ever having an outside John.
Are you talking to me, Nidra? Oh,
I think probably it was a toilet.
Okay, so Nidra says that the White House had indoor plumbing before it had a telephone. Do you agree or disagree, Deborah?
I agree.
It had indoor plumbing before it had a telephone. You're right to agree, and that's
a good thing.
The plumbing was installed in 1834, and the telephone was installed in 1877.
But
and
there the
was...
thing is, when they install a telephone, they put it in the jar.
And as I remember, there was a lot of indoor
because
plumbing going on in 72.
Because that's where most of our presidents spend most of their time. And do their best thinking, too, I think.
Okay, Lori, pick a star for me.
Marky, please.
Mm-hmm. Marky, if you rip off this animal's leg, a new one will grow back. Is it a beetle or a lobster?
I know that. It's a lobster. But first I want to announce that this is my very first Hollywood Squares question, and I'm thrilled. And it is a lobster. Oh, thank you. It is a lobster.
Marky's thrilled, and she thinks she knows the answer. She says that the animal whose leg will grow back is a lobster. Agree or disagree, Lori?
I'll agree.
It is a lobster. You're right Ooh. To agree. Good going, Marky. You get the square, Lori.
Batting 1,000.
Deborah, pick a star.
Jim to block.
Mm-hmm. You get this one, you do block. However, if you miss it, Lori will win the first game. No pressure, Jim.
I'll handle it.
Which of these is considered one of the most effective exercises there is? Is it walking upstairs or making love?
Or making love.
I think the key word, the operant word here is effective. Because so many people make love the wrong way. High divorce rate. Back me up, Gene. So I think...
300 calories if you do it right.
And if you do it wrong, thousands of calories. I think, and Carl Sagan would agree with me, that walking up the stairs is a very good cardiovascular thing. It gets the whole car walking upstairs.
Jim says walking upstairs is more effective exercise than making love. Agree or disagree, Deborah?
I'm sorry, I agree.
Yes, walking upstairs it is. You're right to agree, you get the square, and you do block.
Fun. Very
good. Lori, pick a square for me.
Fred the block.
Right, the tables are turned. You get this one, you block. However, if you miss it, Deborah wins the first game. Fred!
Yes.
Wake up.
Yes.
This man said that until he was 17 years old, he never read anything but comic books. Is he John Travolta or Woody Allen?
Well, I'll tell you the truth. When I was working on Saturday Night Fever, I tried to read as much as I could. Because Sylvester Stallone turned to me one day and said, "Hey, you don't know who you are."
Now, let me have that question again. So,
Was that Woody Allen, Fred?
No, I want the question again, if you don't mind, because it's a very important question, and I'm a sex symbol, and I gotta answer it right.
This man said that until he was 17 years old, he never read anything but comic books. Is he John Travolta or Woody Allen?
I would say the answer to that would be Woody Allen.
Laurie, he says that Woody Allen never read anything but comic books till he was 17. Agree or disagree to block? Yes, it was Woody Allen. You're right, you get the square, and you block. Take a good look at the board, Deborah Disbukes. We got an interesting configuration up there. Pick a star for me.
I would like Sean, please.
Okay.
I don't think she's the only one.
She phrased that in an unusual way. That's why the audience got excited. She said she wants Sean.
And so do they. Sean, you're an average man.
True.
Who do you dream about more, women or other men?
Hey, watch how you answer that, Sean. Your whole career could depend on that. There are girls in the audience. You better watch how you answer that.
That's a loaded question, John. Am I red yet? What else can I say? Women.
Okay.
You have to agree or disagree.
It's a popular answer, but is it right? Sean says that the average man dreams about women more often than other men. Agree or disagree, Deborah?
I agree.
He dreams about other men more often than he dreams about women. Amazing. Okay. Your opponent gets that square. Lori, she's giving you a break. Make your move.
Okay, Audrey to win.
Mm-hmm. This will win you the first game for $100. Audrey.
Yeah.
You've got bubble gum in your hair.
Oh, no.
Let me get it out, please.
If you decide to remove it, should you use peanut butter or chocolate?
Let's see. What did my mother use in my hair when I was a little girl?
Probably chocolate if I know your mother.
No, actually, it was peanut butter.
Okay, Lori, to win the game, should you use peanut butter, she says, to get bubble gum out of your hair?
I'll agree.
Yes, it is. Peanut butter, you were right to agree. You get the square and you win the first game. Okay, our champion is doing well. She's got $225 so far, $50 for you, Deborah, but do not despair. We will be back with a $200 game after these messages.
Stay tuned for more of the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour. Back to John Baldwin and the Hollywood Squares.
All right, our defending champion has forged into the lead with $225 to $50 for you, Deborah. You won the last game, Lori, as we know. That means Deborah gets to start this one. Pick a star.
Jean, please.
Jean.
I'm ready.
Good. What was the first city to have a population of 1 million people? Was it New York City, London, or Pompeii?
Pompeii didn't have 1 million. London had a million people before New York did.
Deborah, he says that it was London out of these three choices to have that million population. Agree or disagree?
I disagree.
It was, in fact, London. No, you should have agreed. Your opponent gets the first square and $25. All right, Lori.
Nidra
Bowles. Over the years, Nidra, have there been more women elected to the United States Senate? You mean I'm on now? Yes, Nidra.
Guess what?
Over the years, have there been more women elected to the United States Senate or placed on the FBI's 10 most wanted list?
You know, those FBI fellas are tricky.
How tricky are they?
Oh, they like women, too, you know. They don't want old women. Well, let me see.
Nidra, you're clear that the FBI is...
FBI. You got any place to go? If you have, I'll go home.
The 10 FBI, most wanted list, yes.
FBI or... What?
Well, it's the FBI's 10 most wanted list, which doesn't necessarily mean that the FBI agents want these women.
Oh, it doesn't mean that. Well, you see,
but it could mean that.
I've been sheltered.
It's either that or the United States Senate. Which has more women?
I think
The FBI wanted list.
Okay, Nidra says that the FBI's 10 most wanted list has had more women than the United States Senate. Agree or disagree, Lori?
I'll agree.
Yes, it is. The FBI's 10 most wanted list. You're right to agree, and you get another square. Okay, Deborah, pick a star for me.
Arsenio to block.
I thought you might. Ooh. You missed this one, Lori wins another game.
Yeah. Arsenio to block.
To block.
Arsenio, who chews their food more thoroughly, a man or a snake?
The difference?
I should be like Fred, just ignore the question and say, you know, if Jimmy Carter were here.
I would go with a snake because, from what I know about snakes, Michael Jackson has a snake. I'm serious, he does have a snake. He has a snake and a llama.
Where does it sleep?
With Michael. Really, it's a snake, a llama, Michael, and Diana Ross. They all sleep together. No, I'm sorry. Sorry, go on. I say snake.
Okay. Deborah, he says a snake chooses food more thoroughly than a man. Agree or disagree?
I disagree.
It is a man who chooses food more thoroughly. You're right to disagree, and you do block. That's right. Snakes, in fact, swallow their food whole.
That's right.
They don't chew at all. Watch out, Michael.
They have terrible table manners, too.
Lori, pick a star.
Audrey.
Audrey Landers. You have a cold and a runny nose. A friend allows you to use his handkerchief. According to Elizabeth Post, is it okay to return the handkerchief used, or should you wash and iron it first?
Oh, no, I'm not good at these. However, I think that if he was polite enough to offer it to me, then I should be polite enough to return it to him directly after I used it.
Lori, she says you should return the handkerchief used rather than wash and iron it first. Agree or disagree?
I disagree.
Yes, you should wash and iron it first. You were right to disagree, and you get the square. And we get to complete this thrilling game right after this. Stay with us. Take a good look at this complex board and make your move.
I'd like Markey, please, to block.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
You missed this one.
Right.
Lori wins the game. Markey Post. Actress Victoria Principal has done something to her bathroom that has made it very special. Has she had a nude mural of herself painted on the wall? Or has she made the whole room bulletproof?
I also happen to know the answer to that. Victoria is a personal friend of mine. I have never used her bathroom. However, if I did, I would not be in danger of being shot because it is bulletproof. She has done that.
Deborah, Markey says that Victoria's bathroom is bulletproof. Agree or disagree to block?
I disagree.
She has made the whole room bulletproof. No, you should have agreed with her. Your opponent gets
a
square, wins that game. Okay, Lori, she helped you out there. On Victoria Principal's bathroom, you won $200. That gets you up to $525. $75 for Deborah so far. Clear the board now. We will move on to another game. Deborah, you have the privilege of starting this one because you lost the last one. Pick a star.
Nidra, please.
There's always a silver lining. Nidra Bowles. According to Young Miss magazine.
Oh, young.
After you take your hat off, what should you do to fluff up your hair? Should you put your head between your legs? Or spray your hair with mineral water?
Spray your legs with mineral water.
Well, I couldn't get down as far as put my head down. I couldn't do that.
Try, Nidra.
I might manage a spray with mineral water, but that other jobby I couldn't do.
Okay, Deborah, she says for the reason of practicality that you should spray your hair with mineral water after you take your hat off. Agree or disagree?
I disagree.
You should spray your hair with mineral water. No, you should have agreed with Nidra, and your opponent gets the first square. Okay, Lori, pick a star for me.
Markey.
Markey Post. According to the Cosmo Report, what is a woman's second favorite place to make love? In the shower or on the floor?
Oh, I know that one too. on the
floor. You said you wouldn't tell.
Can I? On the floor.
On the floor. Okay. Marky says that a woman's second favorite place to make love is on the floor. Agree or disagree, Lori?
I'll agree.
It is on the floor. Yes, you're right to agree, and you get the square.
Where's the first?
Deborah, she's kind of got you by the X's again. Pick a star.
Audrey, please, to block.
Audrey, your face is just broken out with a batch of pimples.
Oh, no, all these terrible things keep happening to me on the show.
Will a day of downhill skiing temporarily improve your complexion, or will it make it worse?
She'll break a leg.
Well, if you run into a tree.
Since exercise is good for your complexion, I would say it would improve my complexion.
Deborah, she says that a day of downhill skiing will temporarily improve your complexion. Agree or disagree to block?
I agree.
It will temporarily improve your complexion. You are right to agree, and you get that square and you block. Oh, but that bell means the time is up with $575. Lori Gause, you are once again our champion. Congratulations, you have done it again. As you know by this time, you can go over there, join Gene Rayburn, get set for another shot at the big buddy. Atta girl. Deborah, time just ran out on you. You have $100. You have our thanks for being such a good contestant on Match Game Hollywood Squares.
Thank you.
And now, Gene Rayburn.
Oh, hey, is he here in person? Yes, sirree. We congratulate Lori, and we'll be back with our 9 celebrities here in a moment or so for the big money right after this.
Now, here to play the super match is Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, Gene. Lori's been here before. She knows how it goes, but just for your information, it's time for the big money super match where she can win up to $30,000, and she's all set, so we'll begin. We polled a recent studio audience, and we said write down your best answer to this. Tooth blank. The top answer is worth $1,000. The second most popular, $500. And the third answer pays $250. You may enlist the aid of any 3 of our 9 celebrities for suggested answers here. One at a time, if you would, please.
Call on me! My grandmother's watching the show!
Can I go with Sean first?
Okay.
Okay.
My grandmother's watching, too. Toothache.
All right, there's one. Toothache.
Okay, Arsenio?
Yeah.
I would go with Tooth Fairy.
You probably would go with the Tooth Fairy. Especially with that outfit on, he'd go with the Tooth Fairy.
I live in West L.A. That's the logical answer.
Well, with your white jacket, what else? I mean, go ahead.
Okay, Jim.
Tooth decay.
Ooh. So we have Tooth Decay, Tooth Fairy, and Toothache.
Hey, it's not a popularity contest.
I was booing Tooth
Decay. That's your grandmother, Jim.
The choice is yours now, Lori, to choose one of those 3 or perhaps contribute one of your own and go with that. What's your pleasure?
Toothache.
Toothache is what she wants. We'll find out how you did. If with toothache, let's see if it's under the $250 response. Toothbrush is there. We didn't get that answer. Let's see what the $500 answer is. Toothache. That's your answer. That was your choice. What do you think's under the big one?
Probably decay.
Tooth decay? What do you think, audience?
It's the fairy. I bet it's the
fairy.
I bet the fairy.
The audience likes fairies.
What do you think?
Toothache.
I say it's
decay.
What I said.
Decay.
All right. Slide
fairy.
The big one.
Fairy. What he said. What the man said was fairy.
Your grandmother is proud of you.
I heard him say it. He said it. That's right.
Pity the fool. That's what I said. Fairy. It's fairy.
That's right.
Cut.
Now, Lori, you have $500. You're going to play the head-to-head match with any star you pick. And you'll notice each star has a concealed number in front of them, a 10, 20, or 30. If you choose a star with a 10, we multiply your money by 10. If you choose one with a 20, we'll multiply by 20. And there's one up there with a 30, remember. If you choose that one, we multiply that $500 by 30, which means you'll be playing for $15,000.
Wow.
Which star do you choose?
Marky.
Marky. All right, would you take the tab and pull it up now?
Pardon me?
The tab. Go. She's a Marky, and she has a 20. That means you're playing a head-to-head for 20 times $500 or $10,000. Mm. All right. Good luck to you. Remember, you'll write yours, and yours will be a verbal response. Here it is. Burt Blank.
Pardon me?
B-U-R-T, Burt Blank.
Love that music.
All right, Marky's ready. Laurie, it's up to you to match her for the $20,000 to collect that. What do you say?
Burt Reynolds.
Burt Reynolds, she says, will match her for the... What do you say?
What do you do?
For the $10,000. Burt Reynolds! All right. That gives her a grand total of $26,250. Congratulations to Laurie! What a win! $26,250, and we'll be back in a moment or so. Laurie's knees are a little bit shaky, so John and I are holding her up.
Tough job, isn't it, Gene? Wasn't it kind of a waste when
somebody's got to do this job, though.
Wasn't it kind of a waste when she hugged Marky?
Well, we can make up for that a little bit later.
I think so.
Listen, let's all pull our tabs up now and find out which star had the big 30. Go. Arsenio had it.
Oh,
Arsenio, John, you had a 20.
Next time
okay.
I see my grandmother's watching, call on me.
Okay, we'll do that. We'll be back tomorrow with our 9 stars here and our champion, Laurie, and John and I will be back here. Are you coming back tomorrow?
I suppose so.
I'll be looking forward to see you then. So long for the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. Goodbye.
A member of our studio audience will receive Quasar. Combines a miniaturized radio cassette unit with a compact headphone stereo. The result is the stylish and versatile double play, furnished by Quasar. This is Gene Wood speaking for the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. A Mark Goodson television production.